Anything that's got a run up, you need to set it up and you need to know where you are in terms of the throw at the end.
Time for the final of the 1500 metres. What a race this promises to be. 13 women. The main protagonists, Muir, Kipyegon and Hassan. Laura Muir, the third part of the triumvirate of excellence. Not quite as quick as Kipyegon and Hassan, but could she finally land herself a global medal? Christina Mackey, PB to make it through. You can't ask any more than that. She should be relaxed and savour the occasion. She's earned the right to be in an Olympic final. So too Marta Perez, fourth in the European indoors earlier this year. This is a massive occasion and she's clearly approaching it with the right mindset. Tanaka Nozomi, world junior champion over 3,000 metres. She broke 4 minutes for the first time to make it into the final. This is an indication of how fast it could be. Winnie Nanyondo, well surely this night couldn't get any better for the Ugandans, could it? She's a great 800 metre runner and she'll really have to go some here to get in the shake-up for the medals at the 15th. Eleanor Purir, national champion for the United States. She's having a sensational season, sixth fastest in the world this year. She won't be afraid to go hard early. And to the first of two Australians in this field, Lyndon Hall, semi-finalist in Rio. She's got one better here. Corianne McGee was upgraded to this final, which is why we have 13 women instead of 12. She has the little R next to her name. She fell in the semis and was heartbroken, but her heartache turns to glory for the final. Second Australian, Jess Hull, an Oceanian record in the semi-final, taking the mark set by her compatriot Lyndon Hall. How well are the Australians doing? Representation in the men's 8 final and 2 in the women's 15. Frewani Gebrehizbiye won the trials for Ethiopia. Yeah, it's your moment to shine. Stay in the limelight a second or two longer. Very, very young and very, very fast. Gabby Dubu Stafford, national record holder for Canada. She made the final last year in Doha and by a couple of hundredths of a second just failed to have her sister in the final with her. Laura Muir, so many European titles, so many near misses on the global stage. She is good enough to get the bronze, but will she get the tactics right? And will she be able to live with the pace that's surely going to be set by the last two women to be introduced? Sifan Hassan, the newly crowned Olympic champion over 5,000 metres. This, the second instalment of what she hopes will be a golden treble. But Faith Kipyegon beat her in the last race before coming here. She is the reigning defending Olympic champion. Surely she is the only one who can stop Hassan winning. Will she go hard or will she sit in? This is the coming together of two once-in-a-generation athletes who have pushed each other and this event to a higher level. The defending Olympic champion against the reigning world champion and 11 other women determined to create their own sporting history in Tokyo. It's time for the women's Olympic final over 1,500 metres. You can feel the tension in the air. One last deep breath. One last moment to focus. And now it's time to deliver.
Somebody dare go out and make the race ahead of those two.
come on.
This has the makings of a very special final indeed. One of the blue-ribboned events of the Games, the women's 1500 metres. Two greats. And guess what? The three best in the field are almost at the back. Sifan Hassan now moving up past the shoulder of Christina Mackey, tracked by Faith Kipyegon and Laura Muir of Great Britain. Content to sit at the back at the moment. Debu Stafford leads, Tanaka second, Puria is there. And look at Sifan Hassan. Usually she stays right at the back until somebody picks up the pace, but she has decided to try and dominate this right from the very start. This is going to be a really, really tough task for Hassan. What tactics does she employ? She's gone to the front, but she hasn't exactly put an electric pace in. She's just decided, though, to sit there and send a little message to Kipyegon and a little message to Laura Muir. 62-plus bits. She'll be very comfortable at this pace. She's saying, OK, this is mine to dictate. Come and have a go.
And the other two can't afford not to go with her. You have somebody else in that pack, jump out a little bit. You can let them go. You don't have to make that. But if it's Sifan Hassan who goes out or any of the other ones go to the front, you've got to be there. You can't let her get away at any point.
The reigning world champion, Sifan Hassan. Kipyegon was second behind her in a classic final in Doha. She got the better of her. Coming in here with a magnificent victory in Monaco with 3:51. She blasted away from Hassan over the last 50. That's Winnie Nanyondo. She's back in the pack, the Ugandan. Gabby Debu Stafford is in third place. Laura Muir's in fourth. No move yet from the Briton. Massive expectation and pressure on her shoulders. She's been so good on the Diamond League circuit and so often got so close to a medal, but she has to get the tactics right if she's to finish in third behind Hassan and Faith Kipyegon, or pull off an unbelievable surprise.
2:07 at the half.
The three main protagonists are first, second and third. Will they finish on the podium? And is that the order? We are edging closer to the conclusion. That's Hall leading a second pack. They've begun to wind it up here. And remember, these conditions are really brutal. I know it's only just under a mile, but it's very hot and sticky here, and their energy will have been sapped heading in towards the last lap. They take the bell. In the final of the women's 1500 metres, the reigning world champion, Sifan Hassan from the Netherlands. The reigning and defending Olympic champion, Faith Kipyegon in second, and Laura Muir of Great Britain, who has missed out on so many occasions for global medals. She's in third. Gabby Debu Stafford running really well for fourth, but now the big three begin to pull away. Kipyegon goes. 200 metres to go. Is this going to be Sifan Hassan's hardest race for gold? She wants a hat-trick. But Faith Kipyegon is a class runner. And Hassan is beginning to tie up. Laura Muir's running the race of her life in second. But look at the margin. Look at the class. And look at the heritage. Faith Kipyegon with the performance of a lifetime. She's the two-time 1500-metre Olympic champion. And at last, at long, long last, after so many years of disappointment on the global stage, Laura Muir takes the silver. She is overwhelmed with emotion. She thoroughly, thoroughly deserves that medal. She's been so close so many times. It was a performance of incredible dominance from Kipyegon. The rivalry emerged. And when the moment came to strike, the reigning world champion, Sifan Hassan, didn't have enough to stop Faith Kipyegon. What a marvellous, marvellous moment for all three of the women on the podium. 59 seconds from Faith Kipyegon on the last lap. I cannot tell you how much joy this performance and this result will bring the athletics fraternity in Great Britain. She has worked so hard, Laura Muir, for so many years, and I am so pleased that she's got her place on the podium. It was the three we were expecting. We had no idea whether it would be Kipyegon or Hassan. And it's the Kenyan flags that will proudly fly tonight. And it wasn't just what she did, it was how she did it. She floated away from an all-time great. And in the process, became one herself.
She's also overwhelmed by the moment. But she is smiling in the joy, and there's... And listen, she sacrificed. She put all her Olympic hopes in this race. And she comes through, sets a PR with 3:54.4, comes in with the silver medal. The 800 was there. We couldn't talk about the 800 without saying Laura Muir chose not to do that. She's focused on the 1500. So there's so much on that, because this is the race you made. This is all of it. And Hassan, who was terrific, she was terrific from the first round, sprinting from 300 meters down after falling. And there won't be the trouble. There could still be three medals. But as you had mentioned, Kipyegon kind of had her measured in this race. She had her covered. You wondered if the fitness would change or if there had something that happened between the two of them in the last race, and it wasn't. They were hip to hip with 400 to go. And when Kipyegon decided to put down the hammer, she literally pounded everyone. And you saw coming just before they came out of the turn, Hassan, whether it was a hiccup or a hitch in her step, whatever, you could tell that she was cooked. She was done. And kudos to Muir for seeing that, recognizing that, and pounced on it. And she went as well. You talked about if Muir could get the tactics right.
She did.
I feel like that's right.
Yep, she absolutely nailed that, because she followed the first two. We weren't being disrespectful to the rest of the field. They were the three outstanding performers of the moment, with Muir sort of in third place in that triumvirate of excellence. She's just run the race of her life. It is as simple as that. She has run the race of her life. You can never ask any more of an athlete than a personal best in a major final. Kipyegon with the Olympic record, Laura Muir with a national record. Her decision to miss out the eight absolutely vindicated. In a race that is often so hard to predict, Faith Kipyegon successfully defends the Olympic title. At last, it's a medal for Laura Muir. It's the silver. This time, Sifan Hassan, the 5,000-meter champion, has to settle for the bronze.
Elaine Thompson had to hold up. She was not able. She was not in full flight when she got that stick.
Wow. No sooner have they raced to history, they're back for the medals. The women's 1500 metres. I'll be curious here to see the reaction of Sifan Hassan. I think she should be rightly proud of this Olympic bronze medal, her second medal. And obviously it's not going to be three gold, but three medals across the 15, 5 and 10 of any colour would be a phenomenal achievement. Paul Turgat, IOC member for Kenya. One of the nicest guys you can ever meet. Five times the world cross-country champion. First man in history to run inside 2:05 for the marathon. And twice second to Gabri Selassie over 10,000. Their battle in Sydney, one of the greatest races over 25 laps you'll ever see. That's Mr. Ahmad Kalkaba Malboum from Cameroon. World Athletics Council member for them. You can see the sweat on his forehead. It's unbelievably humid in the stadium tonight. It really is sticky. Full credit to these athletes for delivering their best under trying circumstances. Well, it wasn't to be the gold. Perhaps if you looked on paper at her three attempts across the 5,000, 1,500 and 10,000, this was arguably the hardest mountain to climb because of the quality that Faith Kipyegon possesses. World champion 2 years ago, But this time it was destined to be bronze, and there is absolutely no disgrace in that. And she comes back tomorrow, or does she, for the 10,000 metres. I still think she will run the 10, because she has another chance of an Olympic medal, and why wouldn't you? But it's bronze this time for Sifan Hassan.
Silver medalist, Great Britain.
And what an achievement. What a moment of unadulterated joy this is for everybody connected to British athletics. You won't find anyone in our country who's willing to say a bad word about Laura Muir. Such a great ambassador for the sport. So many European titles, indoors and out, but the medal she wanted was global. World Championships would have been nice. She was fourth in London in 2017, but this makes up for everything. And guess what? She did it with a national record, and she beat Hassan to the silver. On paper, she was third in this race, and the history books will always say she is an Olympic silver medalist, matching the achievement by Steve Cram back in 1984 and beating Kelly Holmes, 1500 metre British record, the performance of a lifetime from Muir.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion, Kenya.
As it was from this middle distance running queen who is the toast of Kenya tonight, Faith Kipyegon successfully defends the title she won in such fine style 5 years ago, but she knew this was going to be hard. She knows what a special athlete Sifan Hassan is. I mentioned at the start of the race that they've elevated this event to a new level. And once again, it's Kipyegon who's come out on top. Lost her world title to Hassan 2 years ago, but the Dutch woman hasn't got her Olympic gold. That is going back to Kenya, and they will be so proud of her all up and down the Rift Valley, in Nakuru, in Eldoret, all the training grounds, and in Nairobi. They'll all be standing to attention for their national anthem. Another one of those joyous anthems that still rings in your ears long after the night of athletics has finished. An absolutely incredible achievement from Faith Kipyegon. It's a triumvirate of excellence, and it's the Kenyans who come out on top once more. But there will be further battles between Hassan and Kipyegon, and now Muir adds her name to those confrontations.
Can we just make mention of what a difference there was in the two 1500s from Rio to here? We went men 350 to an Olympic record. We went Kipyegon 408 to an Olympic record. Counts the same, right? Gold medals still count the same, but just such different racing. Each one's so unique, right? Each one's individual. They all unfold so differently. But to have just such different spreads between the winning times is really